so perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli and report it.
Sign it. Yeah, I'll sign it.
An easy gale.
To get along with.
If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get. It's Annie I want.
It's Annie you get.
Oh, boy!
So if you'll get her coat, we'll take her right along.
Coat? She don't have no coat.
All right, then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy! I'm getting a coat! She's getting a coat!
Come along, dear. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Oh, boy, I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it.
Say goodbye. Bye, kids. I'm going to offer this. All right, to you. Bye,
Annie. Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan. And season's greetings.
Yes, season's greetings.
Thank you.
my 6 weeks. Where the hell is everybody? Hello?
Sir, welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks. It's good to be home. And how's your flight from Chicago?
Not bad.
17 hours and we only had to land 8 times. Now, first things first. Has the painting arrived from Paris?
Yes, sir. They're just about to hang it now.
Ah, yes. No, I don't think so. Grace?
Yes, sir.
Messages?
Yes, sir. President Roosevelt wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll give that to him tomorrow. Anyone else?
John Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, Harpo Marx.
Nothing urgent. What did Harpo want?
He didn't say.
Wait a minute. Maybe I could learn a little of this thing. Hang it someplace.
Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, and Mrs. Pugh.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, we're going to have New England clam chowder.
Wonderful.
Kentucky fried chicken.
Wonderful.
Idaho potatoes.
I won't be having dinner this evening. I have hours of paperwork to get through.
Wonderful.
When Grace, I'll meet you for dictation.
Yes, sir.
All right. Good to see you all again.
Sir.
Drake. Dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
Grace, if you'll get your notebook, I can... Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks. The orphan will be with us for Christmas.
The orphan? That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose you'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Oh, I don't have a last name that I know of.
So you're just Annie? Huh?
Yes, sir, just Annie. I'm sorry that I'm not a boy.
I don't suppose you'd like to meet Babe Ruth?
Sure! Who's Babe Ruth?
I couldn't be happier that you'll be spending Christmas with us. Grace! So we can start with the figures on the article shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's her first night here.
It is?
Yes.
Oh. First night here, Miami. I suppose we ought to do something special for you. Why don't you sit down?
Well, there's some Christmas.
A movie!
Would you like to go to a movie?
Oh boy, sure! I mean, I've heard about them, but I've never been to one.
Never? Well then, we gotta do something about that right away. And nothing but the best for you, Annie. Let's see. You'll go to the Roxy, then an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's, and then a handsome cab ride around Central Park. Grace, forget about the dictation for tonight. We'll do it first thing in the morning. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Auntie.
Something the matter, Annie?
No, nothing really, sir. It's just Auntie.
No, but what is it, child? You don't want to know the Roxy?
I do. I thought you were going to take me.
Me? Oh, no, I'll be far too busy tonight.
Auntie!
You see, Ann, I've just been away for 6 weeks making an inspection tour of my factories, or what's left of my factory, this damn depression. And when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar...
Sir, I understand.
Excuse me, sir. Bernard Brook calling.
Good. Hello, Barney. I got him about an hour ago. No, Detroit or Chicago. Barney, I didn't like what I saw out there. Factory shut down, my factory shut down. Your darn tootin'. When I'm not making money, nobody is. And gosh darn it, Barney, your pal Roosevelt has got to do something drastic. He's got to come up with a new approach, a new plan, a new something. Yes, I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. All right, come on over. Yeah, we can talk about it. We can go over the... I can show you the...
Warbucks,
party. Make it tomorrow. Tonight. Tonight I got a date to go to the movies. A 10-year-old girl.
11!
I was mistaken. She's 11. Bye, Barney. Drink! Coats?
Yes, sir.
Grace, you'll come to, of course?
Yes.
Will you be watching the Vesley, sir, or the Duesenberg?
The Duesenberg.
Excellent choice.
No, wait. This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. No, Duesenberg. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Sure, why not? It's only 45 blocks. Ah, smell that. Fifth Avenue Buskers. You know, there's no air like the air of New York. And you don't realize how much you miss it. The whole city. Until you've been away from it for a while. Like the man says, after New York, every place else is a rich board. NYC, what is it about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. NYC, I go years without you, that I can get it.